All right, if you guys really want to learn something, this is your chef instructor right here, Kyle Parks from L'Ecole Culinaire. He was already dancing, already singing, because it's National Seafood This Day. You gotta celebrate that.
Amen.
All right, so what is the first thing that we need to do in order? First of all, what is a bisque?
It's basically a soup that we're gonna blend up, all right? And with most soups, we're gonna start with carrots, celery, and onions. So that's what I got going on here inside a little bit of butter.
Gorgeous thing.
And this is the tricky part of the dish. So we're just gonna walk people through this. What you wanna do, you wanna kinda caramelize this up, which I probably won't have the time for, so we're gonna fast forward
a
little
bit. That's all right, he will be right back on our sister station on News 11 at noon, and we will go ahead and caramelize it up.
We're gonna add a little bit of flour to this, so that way, this is gonna be like our thickening agent for the stuff. Now what I have over here, if you would hand me that that glass of stock, we're gonna have some shellfish stock here, in which I just took the shells of the crabs. You could do shrimp, you could do lobsters, anything of that nature. And just slowly but surely kind of whisk that in, you're gonna get this awesome creamy texture going on.
Okay, this is definitely, there is definitely a process to this.
A little bit. This is the tricky part. After that, you sit back, you watch, you know, Channel 2 or something like that.
That's right.
You know, get that plug. And you just relax. You let the pot do the magic for you.
About how long should you cook a bisque?
Really, just until everything is soft and tender, and then you can blend it up. Okay. Last night, I put together a little version in about 40 minutes.
That's not bad.
You could let it go for a long time if you want to. Add a little bit of tomatoes and some garlic. That's going to give you some acidity and that nice little rich flavor. You know, the actual shellfish, the meat, everything like that, you can put on top. You could blend in. It's entirely up to you.
Okay. And so you should cook it separately?
You can. That's what I did. I cooked the crab first and then kind of took out the meat from that. And then you get to save the shells. But you can do it with anything. There's like 81
different versions. 81
that you can have
different
of this.
Versions of the bisque. All right, what's our next step from here?
From here, all we really have to do is just let this get let it get nice and soft. We would throw this into a blender, blend it up, strain it out. And then taste it a lot.
So tell me about the public cooking classes there at L'Ecole, because a lot of people, they want to know how to cook just like this.
Absolutely. Well, we offer them really frequently, and there's a wide range of things that you could do. So if you want to jump on our website, that'll let you know what we have to offer. Come by next Monday. We got the restaurant on campus, brand new menu rolling out, brand new group of students, ready to help you and everything.
So you
like
can
that.
Learn any.
Absolutely. That's the best part. That's the
best everybody, the website is L'Ecole.edu. We will have links on the Fox 2 app. Chef Kyle Parks, thank you so much.
Hey, well, always a pleasure.